Hello everyone, welcome to Positron Plays Even the Ocean. Even the Ocean is an action platformer game from the makers of Anodyne, which came out a few years ago as a kind of a Zelda-like game in a kind of retro style. It's pretty damn good. This is an action platformer game with some puzzling elements, a bit of a narrative focus, and it's about the balance of light and dark energy, essentially. But we'll get started here. I've only played maybe like the first 10 minutes just to see, make sure everything was set up. But we'll start a new game here. Let's see. I want to do new game. Just delete this one. Yes. I am sure. All right. So there's a lot of options in this game. We can do full game, story, gauntlet, or warp. We're going to do full game. This will give us the story elements and the gameplay sections. Challenging sections. Yep. Correct. There's also a lot of options here. I think I need to turn this back down. There's a lot of gameplay options. I'm turning screen flashes and screen shakes off. The rest of this, we're going to leave. Let's see. There's an icon standing over ground that can be jumped down through. No, that's fine. We can... Yeah, we'll leave the rest of these here. I just want to double check my audio settings. I think the volume needs to be at that level. We'll get started here. I had set up the volume of the title screen, but then it changes it when you come to this menu. We'll get a little bit of a narrative sequence here to start. I did. This is our storyteller. Also serves as a tutorial NPC. This shows the light and dark energy stuff. Light energy is green and vertical. Purple energy, or dark energy, is purple and horizontal. So this ends up being a story element and a gameplay element. So I mentioned Whiteforge City, which is kind of the main city in this world. Grand City of Light Energy. The power plants keep things in order, essentially. So we're heading to the Fey Rouge region. We're going to meet Aliph. Aliph will be Aliph? I'm gonna go with Aliph for now. But she'll be our main character. Here we are with some funky power suits. There's Cassidy. And there's us. There's Aleph. So she grew up near here, apparently. And she used to sneak into the power plant. Yeah. Yeah, you probably shouldn't tell your new boss about that. Alright, so there's something wrong with the power plant. We've got to do some repairs. So let's get moving here. The hills of red ferns. I do like the background art. So right now, all we can do is kind of move and jump here in our very clunky suit. That will change pretty quickly. This is going to be tutorial stuff. I'm probably going to pass through these pretty quickly, but this is essentially just saying that we can jump down through thin platforms like you can in a lot of action platform games. Yep. Yeah, so the tutorial stuff I've already gone through. I'll explain it myself. This is a save point. Automatically saves. We can also manually save if I wanted to. Right, so this is a sat pad. And everything works on this energy balance stuff. But our special suits here will actually provide the energy, so we don't have to worry about that. We'll fill this up with purple energy, and we can move through. We can do the same here. No problem. We have these little things here. These are actually kind of like purple and green flowers, interestingly enough. Bit of a rumbling there in the distance. That bridge isn't looking so good. And neither is Cassidy. There's some sort of barrier, energy barrier there. Yeah, getting struck by lightning even in a power suit is probably a bad time. Yeah, and Cassidy didn't quite make it. And our suit is beyond repair at this point. But... ah, yes. So, we get the shield. And this shield is basically going to be the core gameplay mechanic, at least from what I've known so far. Yep, and the storyteller is saying that they'll give us instructions. Right, so we can move the shield around and lock it in a direction as we so choose. Like this. And I can move around in any direction, and I can do that with any orientation of the shield in any direction. Cassidy, however, unfortunately did not make it. So we can see here that if we touch this stuff, it'll charge the green. I'm actually going to show what happens if you hit the max. It kills you. So if you hit the max energy in either direction, it just straight up kills you. You get overloaded, it's a bad time. But we can block it with the shield. Yep, without the shield, we are very vulnerable to the energy levels. So we can see that the plants cannot be absorbed by the shield. They will change our energy as well. We have a lot of dark energy. We move faster left to right. And if we have a lot of green energy, we move faster up and down or further. You can see I'll start moving faster, and you get a trail kind of indicating that that's the case. Also, if you get to extreme levels, the outside edge of the screen will kind of warn you. We can jump pretty high now. And we can also wall jump, which the storyteller is explaining here. Yep. Very Mega Man X style wall jump, and especially because I've got this... You know what I do want to check? I want to check if there's fall damage. I don't think there is. We kind of don't have a health bar, per se. Yep, and we can also jump from one wall to another. Kind of Ninja Gaiden style, if we wanted to. We don't even need to right there. Ah, this cave is attached to the power plant. We gotta go repair the power plant's core and use the radio to call for help at Whiteforge City. I'll let them know what happened. Not only is our boss dead, but something not good is going on in Power Plant Town. Alright, let's block these. So now we kind of get introduced to what I assume are kind of like the main puzzles. Now these sections, as far as I know, you can't block them. You just gradually gain that energy while you're standing in it. So it's a little dangerous. You have to make sure that you're balanced right to be able to go through those without dying. See, now I have like really high green energy. You gotta be careful. I don't know if there's a difference going up or down here. So all I have to do is hold the shield button, which is either one of the face buttons or shoulder button. Then I don't have to worry about changing directions and things like that. Should save, though. And kind of use that to your advantage to get momentum in different directions if you want. I think this is a... Oh, I thought that was a closed door, actually. I wonder what was to the left. So now this panel should take, oh no, that takes green energy. Yeah, okay, so these take green energy to power, give us purple. So I'm actually going to soak up a little more green here. Otherwise, I'm going to kind of be in trouble. There we go, got the doors open, no problem. So I did land on one of those. So now again, you can see that if I just hold the shield in one direction, I can continue running, no problem. Same here. Kind of serene music in the background. Might be a little low, but it'll probably get pretty loud at some point. Soak up a little bit of green here so I can jump higher. Are there any secrets, I wonder? Probably. If I had to guess. Obviously, too, once you kind of get used to the controls, it's easy to just move pretty quickly. There's actually a speedrun mode in the game, too. That I think takes out the story stuff and sets things maybe a little differently. We're gonna get another puzzle element here. Delicate crystal lenses have been fried. Need to put the crystals in with the pink lasers. But if crystal lens hits any sort of energy, it'll shatter. So we get one of these things. We can carry with us. We can just slap it on in there. So you saw that there was that up and down oscillating thing there. So we have to make sure that we move in a way that this crystal does not touch. Now, you don't have to wait for it once you get to the receptacle. Some are horizontal, some are vertical. Let's see, I don't want to do this. I think I'll actually go down there. Oh, nope. Also, I gotta be careful, my energy is actually super high right now. Although it does help me kind of dodge. Can I make it all the way over there? No. I should be able to make this jump though. No, not quite. Almost. There we go. I think I'll actually do what I was gonna do before. Yeah, here we go. Just go down here. Nice. That's the last one. We should be able to activate this console now. I'll save here, just in case. So we have another sort of puzzle element here. Dark beam is grounded. All right, so we need to switch these mirrors. No problem. So we get that sorted. Powering up a bit here. Ignition 03A. ETC was Cassidy. So I guess the letter is their first initial. I think we're okay. I mean, I've got this green glowing thing going on right now, but... So they want us to go back to HQ for debriefing, which sounds a little ominous, doesn't it? Yeah. So, once we get outside, we get kind of a world map here. Inspect different locations by going up to them. The journal let us know where we need to go. Very classic NES RPG or SNES RPG overworld here. And read signs. Southeast to Whiteforge. So there's a couple locations we can't go there quite yet, but like, you know, I can inspect this stuff. I think I can actually inspect one of these over here. This is actually as far as I've been. Yeah, there we go. So we should get back to the city before we do anything else. So I think we'll find the city and then we'll continue next time. Yeah, so I think this will be pretty interesting. I've been kind of following the game for a while, looking at the art and stuff, and I think it'll be kind of a neat little platformer. So we'll continue playing next time. If you have any comments or anything like that, feel free to leave them. Click like if you like the video, subscribe for more, and I'll see you soon.